Hey guys, it's Nicole, and this is going to be a video on a really cool book. It's called The Critical Care Nursing Practice Guide, A Roadmap for Students and New Graduates. This book is sort of geared to ICU, but I feel that this book could help any graduate, whether you're a med-surg or PCU level like myself. This book begins with helping you understand a true head-to-toe assessment. It examines each body system and even goes into a little bit of documentation for you. There's a chapter on meters, mechanical ventilations, and diagnostic tools on an ICU level and a PCU level, whether it's an EKG machine, a mechanical ventilation, or you're looking at a PA cath wave. You will know what is abnormal versus what is normal and what is the clinical picture that your patient is showing you. It also had a chapter for labs, dysrhythmias. The list went on and on. I really love this book. I purchased this book as soon as I passed my NCLEX to get me ready for the critical care setting. I read it from end to end in about a week, and I still reference it from time to time when I'm stuck on something. Once again, here's what it looks like. And let me go to the first chapter. The first chapter is assessing your patient. And this sounds very kind of like boring, but this really showed me some information I didn't get in a lot of books. This is a proper lung auscultation. Every book has its own process, but this is this book here. What else we got here? The different cardiac assessment pinpoints in the thoracic area. Just a refresher for me since I recently graduated. Here we go. Sites of vascular sounds. Now this is something that I didn't know. And I find these on patients all the time. If I press hard enough and hear hard enough, I will definitely find these, but very interesting to know. What else we got going on here? I think that is it for that chapter. The next chapter we have here, labs, levels, and labels. This was another chapter that helped me as far as critical care labs, because it's not always a CBC or a hemogram or a CMP. Sometimes labs I've never heard of, and this book really broke it down. This chapter is on respiratory acidosis and respiratory alkalosis, and it gives you a huge clinical picture. It doesn't just list symptoms. You will know what these values are and what your patient will express. There's also a couple of sections on interpreting ABG, and there's tons of information on that. Really love this book. Goes over electrolytes in detail. I'm talking not just telling you what common symptoms are, but the physiological effect of you having hypocalcemia. Really, really learned my electrolytes on this book. What else we got going on here? Next chapter. Holy crap, I love this chapter. Graphs and waves. Now, I was a nurse tech for 2 years on an ICU floor. When I would see the PA cath wave and all these waves going, I didn't know what they were for, but this book would really help a new graduate going to ICU level or a PCU nurse who's being graduated to ICU level, what you're going to see. Yeah, the basic is explaining an EKG, what the different waves are, and we all know those. Let's try to find something a little harder. But yes, the EKG section is also breaking down the different type of dysrhythmias, like AV blocks. And it goes into great, great, great detail. Love this book. Gives you the different types of MIs and how you would see them on a 12-lead EKG, which I see often. PA catheter wave in the right ventricle. I would see this stuff on monitors and I wouldn't know what they were or what they were indicating. But when you're a ICU nurse, you're expected to know this information. You need to know if it's good or bad. Is your patient, you know, compensating or decompensating? Is it an emergency? And having this knowledge will help you. Really, really, really great section. And this is when the PA cath is not in the right ventricle. The top one, I think, is when the cath is in the pulmonary artery. And then the second one is in the pulmonary capillary. And then the bottom is mechanical ventilation. But you see how the different locations produce different waves. So you need to know the good waves and the bad waves and then what you need to do nursing intervention wise. I really love this book. How to recognize different types of heart blocks and what the nursing interventions are. This is a really great book. I don't carry it to work because it's more skewed towards ICU, but if you're a person who's going in ICU and, you know, as a PCU nurse, you want a little refresher and, you know, go a little in depth ICU wise, this book is amazing. Since ICU is my dream, I feel like I want to stay on top of everything, but I really love this book. It even goes over certain emergencies that are specific to an ICU floor. Love this chapter. Not the fact that people get these emergencies, but I really love this chapter. From cardiac dysrhythmias to asthma exacerbations to cardiac arrests, it gives you the entire clinical picture, what you're going to see, what's going to happen, what you need to get ready for, what you need to bring with you, what things you're going to see. Chest pain, triple A dissection, cardiac trauma, pneumothorax, pulmonary embolism, heart failure. Tons and tons of great stuff. I might reread this. This thing's really good. What else we got going on here for you guys? Procedures in the ICU. I saw, you know, tricks being done at the bedside, bronchoscopies being done, but I never really knew what they were doing. You know, you have your sterile field, a lot of doctors are in there, everyone's in the way. I never understood what was going on. And as a nurse, if I ever became ICU nurse, what I would need to bring. This book gives you all of those things. It explains the procedure to you. It tells you what you need to bring and what you need to monitor post-procedure. Love this book. Love it, love it, love it, love it, love it. And it even goes over certain things like if your patient's fresh out of surgery, what do you need to do? If your patient's fresh out of an ileostomy surgery, what do you need to do? If your patient's getting tube feedings, what do you need to do? And it just gives you a list of things and tasks you need to watch for. I'm really gonna reread this book. It's really good. You know when you have a book and you read it and then you put it on your shelf for like 2 months and you forget how valuable and awesome it is? What else do we have going on here? Some more hemodynamic monitoring and what it indicates. Almost done. Tons of gems in here. Tons of gems. There is even a section which I use this very day on how to plan your day. It helps you as a new nurse understand what's important and what's not important. Granted, every hospital, every floor, every nurse is different, but this gives you a basic layout. I think they even give you like a template to follow. Yeah, this is like a basic day of the template that they give you in the book. And I tweaked it a little bit because, you know, to each his own, but really great format. A really great tool to help out new nurses too. I liked it. And then this chapter was really neat. Special ICUs, you know, neuro, vascular thoracic, you know, all those special ICUs, and they have pictures and information for each one. So if you're going to neurocritical or trauma ICU or cardio ICU, it goes over a little bit of information, not a lot, but definitely well worth the read. I think we have a couple more chapters. Let's see what we got here. Oh, last but not least, documentation. This shows you what you need to document, what's important and what's not important. And as a GN, as a nursing student, you know how important that is. But since you have no hospital experience, or I didn't as a new nurse, this was a chapter that I flagged like all the rest of them and reread over and over again. At the very end, you have your little pearls, just little gems that so that you can prepare yourself to be certified with the AACN. Common labs are on the back here, and that's really it. Here's the book again. As you can see, I tabbed it like crazy. It's on my bookcase. It's not really a book I carry because I'm not really into the mechanical ventilation ICU area, but I bought this book because at some point that will be a destination in my life and I want to be prepared. But if you're a PCU or ICU or even a med-surg nurse and you're having difficulty in planning your day or understanding the critical care field, this book is for you. You don't have to get this book, but get any sort of book that is some sort of road guide to help you understand the field of critical care nursing, because there's a lot of information. This book isn't even that thick, and I read it in a week, And with even just showing you this video, I saw stuff I didn't even see the first time, so I might go back and read this bad boy. But here it is. I hope you guys enjoyed my little book review. Check it out, and that's really it. If you guys have any questions or comments for me, put them on the bottom. Thank you for watching, guys. I appreciate your support, and have a good day. Bye.